Yes, may be seen. Love is like the flame of a candle. It shines brightly throughout our lives as we share. As we celebrate this wedding, we honor those who are not with us tonight. They are with us in our hearts, and I believe that the happiness that they must feel for Brandon and Asher is part of the joy that we all feel tonight. In the presence of God and for their families and these friends, we've come together to unite marriage, Brandon and Asher. We come together not to mark the start of a relationship, but to recognize a bond that already exists. This marriage is one expression of the many varieties of love. Love is one, although its expression is different. It's fitting to speak briefly about love. We live in a world of faith and fear and search for meaning and strength in seeming disorder. We discover the truest guideline to our quest when we realize love in all its magnitudes. Love is the eternal force of life. Love is the force that allows us to face fear and uncertainty. But you must be aware, a little more careful than anything. You begin your married life by the voluntary and complete surrender of your individual lives in the interest of that deep requirement which you are having common. From now on, you will be one in mind, one in heart, and one in affection. This giving of yourself will let us go. So you must learn to give up your love and still remain yourself. Therefore, in your gift, give your joy, your sadness, your interest, your understanding, your knowledge, all expressions that make that life. But in this gift, remember to preserve yourself, your integrity, your individuality. This paradox of becoming one or remaining two is the challenge of love within marriage. A wedding is that occasion when two people publicly proclaim their love and declare their commitment. By its very nature, it's both a solemn and a happy one. For some of us gathered here, this ceremony will prompt a flood of memories. For others of us, it will set emotions, dreams, and aspirations. For all of us, it will be sharing in the most inimitable moment in the lives of two people we know and love. For you, Brandon and Ashlee, this ceremony is an act of anticipation of what you will do to be God's will for your life. And I remind you, that the vows you take this day are sacred above words, and that your lives hereafter shall be bound together in prayer. But the security of your marriage will not rest in any part of friction, nor any performance of it. The security of your marriage will rest in the true purpose of your hearts, in your character, in the steadfastness of your emotions, and in the love of God. You, Brandon, take Ashlee to be your wife. You promise to love her, honor her, comfort and keep her, and forsaking all others, remain true to her as long as you both shall live. If so, you may answer, I do. You Ashlee take Brandon to be your husband. You promise to love him, honor him, comfort and keep him, and forsaking all others, remain true to him as long as you both shall live. If so, you may answer, I do. Although we go forth from the homes of our childhood, we never outgrow the special love and support of our parents. When a father presents his daughter to marriage, he is honored with the covenant in which she is entered, and giving his and her mother's promise of love and support. The veteran's day asks, who presents Ashlee to Brandon, her mother? Ashlee and Brandon chose a passage from Paul's first letter to Corinthians 0. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It is not rude. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angry. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not divide in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails. Please join me in prayer. Eternal God, you have given us a need to love and to be loved, and the capacity to be my life.
My life.
I will share my life with you.
I'll share my life with yours.
Build our dreams together.
Build our dreams together.
Support you through times of trouble.
Support you through times of trouble.
And rejoice with you in times of happiness.
Rejoice with you in times of happiness.
I promise to give you respect.
I promise to give you respect.
Love and loyalty.
Love and loyalty.
Through all the trials and triumphs of our lives.
Through all the trials and triumphs of our lives.
This commitment is made in love.
This commitment is made in love.
Kept in faith.
Kept in faith.
Lived in hope.
Lived in hope.
And made new every day of our lives.
And made new every day of our lives.
I, Ashlee, take you, Brandon, to be my husband. I will share my life with you. Build our dreams together. Support you through times of trouble. And rejoice with you.
Rejoice with you in times of happiness.
I promise to give you respect.
I promise to give you respect.
Love and loyalty. Through all the trials and triumphs of our lives together. This commitment is made in love. Kept in faith. Lived in hope. And made new every day of our lives. For thousands of years, couples have exchanged rings as a symbol of their wedding. What these rings stand for now, what they will come to mean over time, is a long price. The great circle of life is symbolized in these small circles on your fingers. The ring is a material symbol that's been designed to illustrate a spiritual truth. A ring has two characteristics that make it suitable as a reminder to us of the importance of keeping faith in our marriages. First, the ring is a circle. Circles never end, just as your marriage will never end. Difficult times may come, but you have committed yourselves to making your marriage last forever. The unbroken circle of the ring is a symbol of the completeness of your love and a reminder of that never-ending commitment. Second, rings are made from a precious metal, capable of withstanding the test of time. Your wedding bands may bend and change shape as the years pass, but they will not break, a testament to the strength and endurance of the vows you've taken to them. The rings you give and receive this day are the symbols of the endless love between you and this husband and wife. They are a symbol of holiness and of perfection and of peace. The rings are symbols of unity, in which your two lives will now be joined in one unbroken circle. Brandon, do you have a ring as a symbol of it? Ashlee, I give this ring to you.
Ashlee, I give this ring to you.
My best friend.
My best friend.
As a lasting reminder of our vows.
As a lasting reminder of our vows.
And a token of my love and commitment.
And a token of my love and commitment.
Ashlee, do you have a ring as a symbol? Brandon, I give this ring to you, my best friend, as a lasting reminder of our vows, and a symbol of my love and commitment. Ashlee, Brandon, chose another ring by an anonymous author. The author wrote, "Love is friendship that is caught fire. It is quiet understanding, mutual confidence, sharing, and forgiving. It is loyalty through good and bad times. It settles for less than perfection and makes allowances for human weaknesses. Love is content with the present, it hopes for the future, and it doesn't brood over the past. It's the day-in, day-out chronicle of irritations, problems, compromises, small disappointments, big victories, and working toward common goals. If you have love in your life, it can make up for many things that are missing. If you don't have love in your life, no matter what else there is, it's not enough. celebrate your new union and will now take part in the tree planting ceremony. This will symbolize the roots of your relationship and the continued growth of your love as you become each other's family today. Love is the essence of human experience and emotion. It is the root of all and everything we as humans do. Love enriches our experiences and fills our lives with meaning. It gives us a firm base from which to grow, to learn, and to change. Let your relationship and your love for each other be like this tree that you plant today. Let it grow and flourish. Let it stand through harsh winds, rains, and storms, and come through unscathed. Like a tree, your marriage must be resilient. It must weather the challenges of daily life and passage of time. And just like the tree you are planting, marriage requires constant nurturing and nourishment.
Right.